sunshine. Thank you for vitamin D, sun. Shine upon our skin. Our skin is a gift from God. Our skin gives us the power to work under hot conditions. Our skin is a gift. And Lord God, we celebrate black and brown people first of all. And we lift them up to you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God, for over 40 years of not only surviving, but thriving in the midst of opposition, racism, discrimination, segregation, redlining. Lord God, we have risen to the occasion because it was you, Lord Jesus Christ, that brought us through. And Lord God, we lift up all those that lost their lives due to violence, even Mr. Tyrone Franklin that once was in this bank. God, we pray for families that are still surviving, meet every single need. And Lord God, I pray that we stay together as a people. Yes. Help us not to allow this just to be a trend. Yes. Let it go for the next 120 years, yes, over 400 years. Yes. And Lord God, after the emotion lift, give us plans and strategies, yes, implementations. Yes. Allow churches to stop being the worst gangs on the block, but work together as one family, Lord God. Allow the government to come together. Come against that spirit that separates government. We need everybody on the same page.
Congressman, we have Mayor Andre Sayegh, Freeholder Assad Akhtar, Commissioner from the School Board Emmanuel Capers, Councilman Ruby Cotton, Councilman Al Abadaziz. We have, as you saw, Councilwoman Lalisa Mims, Commissioner Manny Martinez, Commissioner Kenny Simmons, been up here since 7 o'clock cooking. Let's give Kenny Simmons a big round of applause. He's the one with the free food with the Greek organizations giving away. We have it always here with us, the Bronze Heat and the Bronze Shields, always here with us. Commissioner Corey Teague, Councilwoman Ruby Cotton. We have Daniel, Lieutenant Sharon Easton in Community Policing, who's always out front. And you know what? We got a lot of people here, but we're not done to talk this. Please, charge it to my head, not to my heart today. So you know who your elected officials are. I want all of the elected officials to stand right in the front, right here. Some of them work your way around, though. Make your way around. Congressman, come up on the stage. Congressman, come up on the stage. Everybody else, stay out front. We have Commissioner Bridget Arick, who I believe is the first African-American commissioner for the Manchester School Board. Let's represent. You know that. Old Manchester is, and Prospect Park is the 7th Ward of Paterson, that's all. We got it. We also want to thank our mayor yesterday, Andre Sayegh, and the city council for declaring Juneteenth a paid holiday in Paterson. Juneteenth was off yesterday. He was bold enough to make it after I texted him 4 o'clock in the morning, but he did it. But let's make sure that next year we don't have a discussion. Juneteenth will be a paid holiday. There should be a national holiday. Now, what you need to know, as you march on November 3rd, you have to vote. You have to vote. The orange man is out in Tulsa somewhere today doing something crazy with 19,000 people. I don't know if he's trying to kill them or give them Kool-Aid, but we need to know on November 3rd, we have to vote. And you need to vote for people who represent your best interests. I'm not talking about Democrat, Republican, or Independent. I'm talking about people who represent your best interests. Do your homework. Know who people are doing when they talk about legislation. Some people get elected and get real lazy. They get real lazy. But I can tell you this. I want the congressman to stand up here with us today because I know he supports us 100% in the legislators here. The Black Legislative Caucus of New Jersey, we are on it. We have 6 bills that passed on Monday. And I want my, yes, 6. And one, I will tell you this. Our assemblywoman introduced the chokehold bill in 2015. And it didn't pass. Listen to what I'm saying. In 2015, the chokehold bill didn't pass. On Monday, we had bills, and she'll talk about it, from diversifying our police force to diversifying our jury pool. There's so many things that make common sense that did not get a unanimous vote. So go online and see what they're voting. See, and not just in New Jersey, throughout, because even though we represent you, we represent all 9 million. We don't just vote for Paterson, we vote for everybody. So see what they're doing. If you don't like what they're doing, turn up the fire.
Thank you. Black lives?
Hey.
Black lives?
Hey.
So as your representative from the city of Paterson, we passed 75 people voted for the no chokehold in the state of New Jersey this past Thursday. Also, my partner, the Assemblyman, finally got the decriminalization of marijuana passed through the Assembly. No more life sentences for carrying 2 ounces, 50 grams of marijuana. No more. I'm putting an end to it. We also passed the false 911 reporting. So if you want to bird watch in East Side Park, you can bird watch in East Side Park and not worry about somebody calling 911 because you're a black person looking at a blue jay or a red robin in East Side Park. We also passed legislation because we need more black people in law enforcement. We need more black people in law enforcement. We are looking to make sure that there are recruitment efforts for African Americans and minorities to go into law enforcement. The state police of New Jersey has 4% of African Americans working for the state police. 4%. We need you young people to go into law enforcement so we have some fair enforcement. We need you all. We also pass implicit bias training for law enforcement. That's important so they know how to treat us. It's also important for their peers to say something when they see something. Other officers were with the man who stood on George Floyd's neck, and they didn't do anything. So we need to make sure that they're saying something and that they have the right to say something and that there's a penalty when they don't say anything. We are working for you all in New Jersey. We have some more bills that we're putting forth, the body cam bill. You will see that coming out soon. So please be on the lookout. The work that we do is not work that we take lightly. It is work that you send us to Trenton to do. Another thing, in March, before COVID happened, we passed so that voter rights would be restored for persons who are on probation and parole. Please tell anybody you know who may have a charge, who may be on probation, who may be on parole, that they can vote. Please make sure they know their right, because every vote counts. You heard my teammate, he said we need to get the orange man
So we know the fight that he has in D.C. Everything that we try to put up that benefits minorities never makes it through the Senate. The House will pass it. There's a bunch of stimulus bills that could get our lives back in order. I'm going to ask, with all due respect to our congressman and to our mayor, that they give us 1 minute of remarks, 1 minute, and then I'm going to get back to our young people, and we're going to wrap it up. We good with that, people? Can I get our permission? Can I get permission from everybody here? We good? Brother Riddle, we're good. Congressman Bill Pascrell, 2020, back to Congress.
All right, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Benjie. Thank you, Shavonda. Ladies and gentlemen, Crystal said it all. That little girl, when she was up here, she spoke from her heart. Let's give her another round of applause. She did a fantastic job, Crystal. I'm going back to Washington this week, and I'm going to make sure we're going to introduce June 19th as a national holiday. That's what we need. And finally, in the Congress of the United States, we need to pass finally, because they jerked around with it for 20 years, ending lynching, ending chokeholds. This is what we need to do. We know what we need to do. God bless you, your families. It was a great march. Good thing I wore my sneakers, else I would have made it. God bless you all. Have a beautiful day. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Paterson. Take a look around. This is what solidarity looks like. Juneteenth gives us an opportunity to reflect, rejoice, and most importantly, unite. And we unite by saying that Black lives matter and Black history matters as well. No one should ever ask what Juneteenth means ever again. Juneteenth should be ingrained in everyone's mind as freedom. July 4th didn't mean independence for everyone, but Juneteenth means freedom for us. Freeing our minds of the sin of racism, and more importantly, freeing our hearts of the sin of racism. So as long as I'm mayor, we will celebrate Juneteenth in Paterson as a paid holiday, so everyone knows what the meaning is of Juneteenth. Thank you very much.
I love it when politicians are that quick. Can we give them some love for that? A couple of facts. When you talk about the shortage of African Americans in law enforcement, the national number for Black male teachers is 2%.
Wow.
Only 2%. So we have to make sure we also recruit more people, Black men in particular, that go into education, because they need to see people that they can relate to. They need kindergarten teachers that look like them. They need first grade teachers that look like them. They need administrators that look like them. They need lawyers that look like them. They need judges that look like them. They need a jury pool that looks like them. But the eight ball that people don't want to talk about are, here are some of the facts with Black people in America. From 1619 to 1865, we were enslaved, 246 years of slavery. From 1865 to 1964, 99 years of Jim Crow laws and segregation. From 1968 to present, we've dealt with everything from redlining to mass incarceration to police brutality to this day. So if you don't think Black Lives Matter now, when does it? We've done our time. We've done our time. What other people have been enslaved for 246 years and haven't survived? What other people have been in there and had a Black president, Barack Hussein Obama? Think about it. We have had a dirt knee on our neck for more than 8 minutes and 46 seconds. For a lot longer. So think about it. We deserve better. So at this time.
You think you own whatever land you land on. Is just a dead thing you can claim, but I know every rock and tree and creature has a life, has a spirit, has a name. Think the only people who are people are the people who love. of a stranger.